Our big story this morning, as the General Assembly winds down its session, some tough anti-gang legislation is facing a major vote this morning.
Lebanon's reporter Carrie Cavanaugh joins us in the studio with more details. Good morning, Carrie.
Good morning. Hi there, Mindy and Stan. The Baltimore City State's Attorney's Office announced yesterday the 2010 Gang Act is scheduled for a vote in the House of Delegates today. The bill would make it illegal to organize, manage, or finance a criminal gang. And under that legislation, gang leaders could receive up to 20 years in prison if convicted.
When it comes to the surge of gangs in Maryland, there's a sense of urgency at all levels of the criminal justice system.
We have seen a rising number of these very violent gangs in our city, and prosecutors in Maryland lack the tools to seek convictions and penalties that are appropriate for this level of violence.
State lawmakers passed the Gang Prosecution Act of 2007 to make it easier to charge gang members and pursue stiffer prison terms. But prosecutors say that legislation missed the mark and made it so difficult to define gang activity that only one gang member has ever been charged under the law. Prosecutors want to revamp that law by clarifying what it means to be in a gang and mandating longer sentences for proven gang activity.
That's not a deterrence. Even if you identify a gang, again, it is not illegal to be a part of a gang. We could call police officers a gang of blue. We could call members of a church a gang. I mean, the definition would be so broad. The activity is what triggers enforcement action.
Dr. Tyrone Powers of the Homeland Security and Criminal Justice Institute argues that gang members don't consider the punishment before they commit a crime.
Expanding the legislation will make people feel good. It would say that we're doing something about gangs, that the legislature is doing something about gangs. But the real deterrent in gang activity is going to be intervention on the front end.
Which means, Powers says, targeting kids as early as elementary school to keep them out of gangs. He adds that prosecutors could win stiffer sentences for gang members by more aggressively charging them under existing laws.
To charge them so to the point where maybe they volunteer information on other activities that the gang is involved in, and you go charge those specific crimes.
The bill showed strong support during a reading in the House on Friday. If passed, the bill will then head on to the Senate. Reporting live in the studio, I'm Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.